to be able to network with Grammy Award winning producers and songwriting teams, that is an opportunity of a lifetime. So I'm 1,000% happy that I signed up for this. Just to be able to network with them. You know how much people pay just for like a meet and greet? What's good, everybody? It's Amare the A-Side, aka Jermaine Price, or Jermaine Price, aka Amare the A-Side. However you know me, and I really just want to talk to y'all. Basically, today was the first day of Maps for Music, and it was a pretty dope experience. I'm not gonna lie. It was a really dope experience. I got to network with a lot of dope artists. They had some pretty good, they had some good mentors and presenters and instructors coming to the class. And it's really not like a class, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not really a class. It's more like it's a forum in a sense. It's like a forum, you know, they have the presenter and really, they just came in. We asked whatever questions we had about the music industry, whether it's how do you approach, you know, local venues, or you know, what is it gonna take to get you as like a, you know, to even perform at something like the Promontory. You know what I'm saying? From performing at, you know, for at like a big arena to the Promontory. You know, talked about that. Really dope presenters. I had a really good time. I'm really excited about tomorrow. They got a special guest that's gonna come in. We're gonna get to talk to them. We're gonna get to, you know, basically get to ask Twister and some other guys. We're gonna get to ask Twister and some other guys some just about the industry. I don't know exactly what the other positions are. I know one is an A&R, and I don't know who the other dude is, but I gotta I'm gonna Google them and just see what they about, so I know the right questions to ask. I'm looking forward to this. Everybody seemed really humble, you know, like all the instructors, they seem really humble. I'm looking forward to this EP. I'm really curious what the expectation is. I feel like the thing is, I don't know, in my mind, I feel like it's a, I'm not saying they have like, they want a traditional Chicago sound. Obviously, they wouldn't have got all these different artists from all these different genres to collaborate and try to make a solid sound. But the thing is, how do you make, you know, how do you take a, you know, possible punk rock, fucking country, you know, Spanish, to R&B, rap, and all that, and mix it on a production level and make it a one meshable project. And to do that in, when we only have Saturday is our production day, you know what I'm saying? So we really, and it's, we're going 4 weeks, so we got 4 days, 2 hours a day, 3 hours, 11 to 2, 3 hours that we're gonna work on the music, you know what I'm saying? So that's like, and we got 30 people. So you think that's a lot. We're getting a little bit of time. So I think we're gonna have to be able to, this is gonna be a test of, one, being able to be a high performer. You know, I think this is a test of high performance and being able to produce high quality work at a fast pace, you know, with the music. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think this is a test of that. I don't think we're being necessarily graded, or I ain't gonna get an F or nothing like that, but I think it's definitely a test of that in my mind. This is what I'm preparing my mind for, you know. I really wanna get, I'm not gonna lie, I want some more credits as far as like on the project. I do want some production credit. I just started making beats in like August, and I'm really like in a place where I'm like comfortable to let people hear my beats and stuff. And I don't make trap beats. I don't do R&B. It's more like grungy, you know, 90s, hip hop, boom bap, you know what I'm saying? Type of like Wu-Tang-ish type beats, you know what I'm saying? Derringer, you know, that's more my lane of what I'm comfortable with, you know? And I'm not sure if that fits with what everybody else. I mean, it's some rappers in there that got names like Killa and, you know, Shotgun, whoever the fuck, Gun, Timmy Gun or whatever, something like that. I don't know. I can't remember the dude's name, but I'm just saying, so they might like the grunge rap, the, you know. So I'm going to start listening to some of the other artists I actually did. I went and listened to the ones that I could find. I listened to some of their music and see what they're about. It's not a lot of rappers, but it's a lot of songwriters and singers, you know, which I think it gives me a little bit of an upper hand because I rap myself, but I can write R&B for other people, you know? So I think, and I can produce or just like help arrange. So I do have a little bit. I'm not just a rapper, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna try to bring all those skills that I've been honing in on for the last couple of years and just, you know, put it towards this project and see what I can get done. I'm not putting no pressure on myself. It's gonna work out the way that God wanted to work out, but at the end of the day, this is what I want, you know what I'm saying? My goal at the end of the day too is my goal, what I expect from, you know, this whole experience is one, networks, bottom line. You know, network, be able to build network relationships with people, which is one of the most crucial parts of the industry. No matter whether it's music, TV, being in television, I only applied for one job, but I had several. You know what I'm saying? Like, every other job that I got after that initial job was based on the relationships that I had with people that I met at the first job and how we vibe together. And then they just put me on the other opportunities. Music the same way. You know what I'm saying? It's the industry. So I understand that aspect of it. And being able to get into a good position in a networking opportunity, you know what I'm saying? The networking opportunity to be able to network with Grammy Award winning producers and songwriting teams, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's an opportunity of a lifetime. That is an opportunity of a lifetime. So I'm 1,000% happy that I signed up for this. Just being able to network with them, you know what I'm saying? Like, real, just to be 1,000% honest, just to be able to network with them. You know how much people pay just for like a meet and greet? You know what I'm saying? Like, for the price of, well, less than a Beyonce meet and greet, I get to learn the game from a platinum, gold record, Grammy Award winning, you know, multi-platinum, Grammy Award winning fucking producer, songwriting team. I get to work with them, you know? This is, and I got it at a discount. Like, really. Like, straight up, got it at a whole discount. Valentine's Day discount, you know? But yeah, I want to document this because, man, this is a dope experience. I knew 2020 was gonna bring something crazy. And I knew that if I gave myself everything that I gave the job that I was working, it's no way I can fail. And the way things are lining up, man, by the end of this year, I'm gonna really be, you know, my goal is to make money off this, bottom line. I'm trying to make a living off music. I don't wanna work for nobody ever again, unless it is my business doing business with their business. Only way I want to work for somebody is B2B. You know what I'm saying? Like, your company hired mine. Simple as that. For this job. Or maybe we have a contract or something like that. You know, for production or whatever. But, yeah. This is what I want to do. This is what I'm gonna do for the rest of my life. Music. That's it. So, hey, it's no turning back now. I'm 38. One of the dudes in the class, 15 years old. So that's dope. That's dope. But yeah, man, I just wanted to do a real quick recap or just my little confessional, because I had a really dope time today. Really dope time. And I really look forward to everything that's about to happen with this damn program. All right.
Well,
I guess that's it. I'll holler at y'all. I'll see y'all next time. Peace.